to win. He fell way behind, got down 17, had long periods of this game where Justin Herbert was really struggling, the offense was stagnant, the furious cutback. So they got to make a play on defense right here, though.
Yeah, big game on third.
Close.
Now they're running up the clock.
Next time they'll snap it. See when they restart after the chains are set. Team in the Territorial Cup, which is a big deal around here, a bit of rivalry. And Arizona State, given little chance, writes another chapter in the upset history here in the desert. The Ducks are down as playoff contenders. Still alive, of course, for the Pac-12 Championship with a beautiful prize of the Rose Bowl. And Herm Edwards had a calm and a confidence really this week, despite the four-game skid that his team would come up with a big performance, is with Maria.
All right, thanks, Chris. Coach, it was a four-game losing streak. You hadn't had a lead since October. What allowed your team to come in and shock the world?
Well, I think their resilience. We talked about it all week, that we were going to have to play good. And these guys are a heck of a football team. They made it interesting. It was good for television, this game, that's for sure. So even though you came to cover a 5-5 team, we made it good for television.
You made it more than good for television, Coach. Walk me through 3rd and 16, the plays that your quarterback, a true freshman, was making all over this field. You needed them.
It's fun happening. And every time you play, it's good. As I told him in the last series, I said, hey, Pat, can you throw a touchdown? You threw a touchdown. So he's a good listener.
What does a win like this mean for your program to knock off Oregon, the top 6-best team in the nation?
Coaches, you know, losing 4 games in a row is tough. Obviously, now we won 6. We're bowl eligible. We got to help with these young freshmen that we're bringing in, so that's a good sign.
What do you want everyone to know about Arizona State football? You've got the national stage in front of you.
Well, I think we're trying to build a program. It's been a lot of fun. I tell you what, I don't sleep good at night, though.
All right, sleep good. Spend a lot of time with your friends.
All right, Maria, thank you. They stored the wrestling mat last night. And a storm in the football field. It's a party weekend in Tempe. Look out, Middle Street. And just beginning.
He's looking for his mom going up into the stands.
We're wondering about from her and some love for the Sun Devil fans. This guy has so much talent and so much cool. And all the qualities you really want in the quarterback. He showed some toughness that I like when they were up against it.
Yeah, sure did. He's up the stands, by the way. High-fiving people.
Oh, there you go. He's taking an unusual way to exit the field.
And he is going to be fun to watch grow here in Tempe. A true freshman. Just threw for 408 yards and 3 touchdowns.
It was fun to watch tonight. Oregon, their first conference loss, had long ago clinched the door. Utah continues to lead 14-0 at Arizona. They must lose for USC to have a chance. USC, the Ducks still on a collision course, it appears, but the Ducks will not arrive with the playoff as a possibility. As Herm Edwards says, we play to win the game. Arizona State won the game tonight, surprising a lot of people. 31-28, a thriller out here in the desert tonight. We're glad you joined us. He finally found his mom.
Yeah.
Tonight's game produced by Bill Bonnell, directed by Derek Motley. We thank our crew as the party continues to build here on the field. A sweet one for Arizona State. And you can scratch Oregon off the list of playoff teams. Cassidy Everett has much more. Wrapping up this day of college football, the four wrap-up show is coming up right now.
Welcome to the Ford Wrap-Up. I'm Cassidy Hubbard. Now, the good news for Oregon fans, the Ducks have already claimed.